Welcome back to this AWS TechShift Migrate and Modernize video mini-series. These videos are aimed at independent software vendors who are currently running on-premise and looking to migrate to the cloud. It's also aimed at those that have existing architectures that are looking to re-architect to become more cloud-native. In the last video, we re-platformed the database layer from the EC2 instance to Amazon Aurora MySQL. We also introduced Amazon S3 as a way to store our static image content. We then added Amazon CloudFront to cache this static content closer to the end users using the AWS edge locations. In this video, we're going to focus on automatically scaling the EC2 instances that are serving the dynamic web content. We'll also explore the benefits of infrastructure as code. Up until now, the dynamic content has been served by a single EC2 instance connected to the database. To scale the web server and increase resilience, we need to add more instances. To do this, we will first introduce an application load balancer between the CloudFront distribution and the EC2 instance. Application load balancers are part of the Elastic load balancing family and operate at layer 7 to balance HTTP and HTTPS traffic. They can support HTTPS termination to help manage SSL certificates. The ALB will balance traffic between web server nodes as well as being responsible for determining the health of instances. If an instance becomes unhealthy, it will be taken out of service and the load balancer won't route traffic to it. Now that we have the load balancer in place, we can create more instances running the same application software behind it. Note how the new instance is in a different availability zone for increased resilience. To avoid having to install and configure the application software every time a new instance is added to the load balancer, a template of the image instance should be created. In AWS, this template is called an Amazon Machine Image, or an AMI. An AMI contains the operating system, all its configuration, software packages, and the data ready to create multiple copies of the same instance. In this simplified view of the architecture, we can now use the AMI to create an EC2 auto-scaling group. The auto-scaling group, or ASG, will add and remove instances using the configured AMI as a template. The ASG can be configured with a scaling policy to automatically add or remove instances based on a specific metric. It could be the number of requests per second on the load balancer, or the CPU usage of the instance, for example. Another benefit to using an ASG is that it can be configured with a minimum number of healthy instances to maintain. In this case, we have lost an availability zone, so the ASG has recreated the lost instances in the other remaining AZ. This ensures there is no impact to the performance for end users. The Photo Gallery application architecture now offers scalability and provides increased resilience and performance. However, there are more components than the original single EC2 instance. Setting up this architecture from scratch manually, either through the console or via the CLI, can be time consuming, and creating multiple identical deployments of the same environment could be challenging. To address this challenge, we should define the infrastructure as code. AWS CloudFormation lets you model, provision, and manage AWS resources by treating infrastructure as code. Using CloudFormation, you can define your resources in files using either JSON or YAML syntax. These files can then be used to deploy copies of the entire application infrastructure to facilitate multiple test environments or individual environments per tenant. It also serves as a form of documentation, meaning that the environment can quickly be reprovisioned in the event of a disaster recovery situation. it's best to version control your CloudFormation template in a Git repository. AWS Code Commit is a managed source control service where you can host private Git repositories. This will ensure your template changes are version controlled and changes are tracked with appropriate approvals. Join us in the next video where we will summarize everything we have done so far and look at where to go next.